For many, buying a barge is a lifelong ambition, up there with getting yourself a holiday home in the sun or a cottage in the countryside. An estate agent, Ian Titchener, is a man who can make that dream a reality.
Good morning, River Homes. Ian speaking. And how long is the vessel?
Ian knows that luxury on the water comes at a premium.
OK, that sounds perfect.
River property is very much sought after, really for the lifestyle. The range of customers we typically deal with will look to spend £90,000 and then upwards of £3.5 million. That's their type of budgets.
There's one major reason why homes on the water are often the preserve of the super rich. Because they can move around, they're not signed up with the land registry. And that means the bank won't lend you the money to buy one.
What a lot of people don't necessarily understand is you can't get a mortgage on a boat. The typical buyers we deal with are all cash.
And if you've got millions in cash to drop on a boat, you may be interested in the latest addition to Ian's portfolio, which he's viewing today. Savvy is a 100-foot vessel moored in Chelsea, one of the poshest parts of London.
Beautiful location. You've got Albert Bridge in the background. On a glorious day like today, you could just decide, well, let's go out for a cruise. On board Savvy, you've got a beautiful living area. The interior has been finished incredibly well. Every detail is important. For example, these lamps we have here, the shades are actually porcupine quill. And the table you can see over there in the lounge is actually manta ray skin. All of these items were ethically sourced. And then the TV is cleverly fitted and hidden away within this unit here. This is the galley, the kitchen. It's quite common for people who have million-pound barges to hire a celebrity chef. And of course, you want to show them off. And there you go. Your celebrity chef is on display to your guests.
On the lower deck, Savvy has two ensuite guest bedrooms. Accommodation for crew members, of course. And a full-width state bedroom. Apparently, that's what you call a master bedroom on a barge.
A beautiful ensuite. All the facilities, bar, even a nice shower cubicle. And a great feature here, we open these, you can line your bath and look out to the stars at night.
So how much would Savvy set you back? And remember, you have to pay in cash.
Whilst the mooring is incredible, the true value really is within the vessel itself. This is a £2 million boat. Very comparable to a penthouse apartment locally. Savvy's a really unique vessel. She oozes character, and we truly don't expect her to be on the market for long.
Back in the world of mega million-pound barges, it's judgment day for Rob. After giving up his job and investing his savings into buying and renovating his barge, it's finally time for estate agent Ian Titchener to value his creation.
Rob and I have actually spoken many a times over the phone. He's exchanged with me all of his plans. I've seen the survey to the boat, so we're going to go and see the value of the boat just to see what we can do for him in terms of positioning onto the market. Should be very exciting.
Rob is determined to sell his opulent vision to Ian, but will his quirky touches impress? After 5 long years of work, will Rob achieve the million-pound valuation that he so desperately needs?
Let's go.
Rob, it's great to have these. It's such an expansive light coming in, and so you've got the nature straight out there.
In its finished glory, Rob's 3-bedroom luxury barge features £15,000 worth of exclusive porcelainosa tiling, a £40,000 kitchen, including a £4,000 oven, and a bespoke £10,000 Macassar ebony wardrobe.
So it's not quite finished at the moment?
We're nearly there. You'll see we're doing a bit downstairs at the moment. It's really just finishing touches, finishing the walls, yep. Doing some painting in the back.
Well, should we go down to the lower deck and
take a look?
Absolutely. So this is the moss wall?
Real moss from Portugal.
So what was the thought process to have a moss wall on a boat?
I really wanted to have a natural touch. It's deflecting a little bit from some of the harsher metal yes. elements in here, so I wanted to break all of that up with something that really grabs the attention when you walk down from the kitchen to the living room.
Yeah. So we're now in the bow of the boat.
Everything in this room is symmetrical, and I've tried to do the same with the bed. It's been very hard to make this headboard because it's just such an unusual shape.
Great
I've
detail.
Tried to use every last square inch of the boat to get the most space out of the room and really push the bed all the way into the bow, so you've got some space here to have a big bedroom and a big bed.
If you thought the moss wall was eccentric, Rob's guest wardrobe is truly individual.
Bedroom two.
Wow, incredible.
So the wood is Makassar ebony. It's a hardwood from Indonesia. It's extremely rare. It only grows in a 10 square kilometer patch of land in Indonesia. We've used it here partly because the lines accentuate the height of the room, and we've tried to just integrate it all the way across wardrobe, connection door, through to the ensuite bathroom.
Right.
Wide wardrobe.
Rob has packed his unique vessel with one-off features and opulent details that you won't find anywhere else in the world. But has he done enough to achieve that all-important million-pound valuation? After 5 years of working on the barge and investing all that he has, will it all have been worth it? At Canary Wharf, in the heartland of the mega-rich wheelers and dealers of London, Rob has done all he can to impress Ian. Having given his savings and 5 years of his life to his luxury barge, it all now rests on Ian's valuation. Will Rob's million-pound gamble pay off?
So, when was she last out of the water for a survey?
5 years ago.
So the natural thing to do is to have her taken out again, dry docks, full survey. So then when we're presenting to the market, the buyer is confident in the fact that there's a new survey out there, they can have a look at that.
Absolutely.
And then fundamentally what I need to do for you, Rob, is to find a mooring.
Yeah.
Probably looking southwest London. I've got some good contacts, I've got some possibilities.
Great.
And I need to have some conversations with them to see if we can either buy the mooring or if they'd consider a joint venture.
Okay.
So in terms of presenting onto the market, I'd actually present the boat onto the market at 1.25 million.
Fantastic.
Does that sound about right to yourself?
I've put a lot of blood, sweat and tears into this project, as have many others, so I'm very relieved to hear that we're not going to be losing money. I hope we can find somebody that it really appeals to.
Ian's valuation of £1.25 million could see Rob make a profit of £250,000 from a sale after all his costs.